is based in the Deep South in the wake of Hurricane Katrina. It's the story of two young girls, a young white girl and a young black girl. The white girl is involved in a car accident, and they hit and kill the young black girl right at the beginning of the story, so I'm not ruining anything. And the narrative unfolds as the story of the young white girl who becomes obsessed with trying to find the identity of the girl that she killed, who was classified a Jane Doe, or an unknown death. And it's the story of the white girl tracking back the steps of the girl she killed, and the story of the black girl who has escaped out of New Orleans in the wake of Hurricane Katrina to try and get help for her family. It's been almost 11 years now since Hurricane Katrina hit in New Orleans, and I actually started writing the book a little closer to when the storm happened. I had been a grief and trauma counselor and had done consulting work for the government and for the states when disasters like Katrina happened. I actually was on the team that would have gone to Katrina to provide counseling to the survivors of that storm, except that I had a newborn baby at that time and stayed home. But telling the story of that storm allowed me to use my former experience as a counselor working with survivors of disasters and kind of add that understanding into the narrative. I grew up in the South. I'm from Virginia originally, and I went to school in Tuscaloosa at the University of Alabama, which is where half of this story is set. And I probably spent rather too much time partying in New Orleans when I was a university student. But setting the story in that place, in places I knew and places I loved, it allowed me, at a time when I was a single mom to two babies and couldn't travel to do research on a story, it allowed me to write about places I already knew very well without having to go back and revisit them. When I decided to write my second book, Landfall is my second book, my first was a memoir of the years I lived in Guatemala at the end of the Civil War. I wanted to write another memoir. I wanted to write a book of family stories. And I sat my mom and my sisters down, and I told them that, you know, I plan to write a book about us, about all of our family stories. And they burst into tears, and they cried, and they begged me, please, not to do it. They didn't want a book that revealed our family secrets. And so we laugh now and say that when my family refused to let me tell the truth, I had to go and make something up. But what I did is I set within the environment of Hurricane Katrina and New Orleans those exact same family stories that I wanted to tell anyway. I took the experiences that I wanted to write about, which in many ways was the way in which we misunderstand the people we love the most, that sometimes the people we're closest to in proximity, the people who live right in our own houses, are the people we fail to understand because we cannot help but push our own perceptions onto the things that they do and they say, and how often we are disconnected from the people that we love. And so I took those same stories and I gave them to the characters in Landfall. I'm not quite sure why my family doesn't realize I did write that book of family stories. Instead, they just think it's fiction. They think I made it up. Everyone here is asking me that. Believe it or not, I have never seen Tremé. No, I haven't. But part of it is that when I decided I was going to write about Katrina and New Orleans, I wanted to be really careful not to sort of accidentally plagiarize somebody else's work. I'm a very visual person, so if I see something, I remember it. It sort of just becomes part of me. And so I was very careful not to read anyone else's books or watch shows, any like movies, creative endeavors about Katrina. I read every journalistic word that was ever written, every newspaper article. I watched every interview with every survivor. But those were straight facts, and that was fine for research. I just didn't go near any of the creative work because I didn't want it to interfere with my imagination. So now I get to watch Tremé. And I'll actually sort of tell a bit of a personal story in that, you know, when I was traveling through the South when I was promoting this book, I was a little worried that people in the South might feel like I had some way sort of stolen their story. That experience, I think, is often believed to be owned by the people who live through it. And yet, I think what often happens is in a chaotic, desperate situation, any kind of terrorist attack or natural disaster, those of us who aren't right there, we hear all the numbers and we learn about all the statistics, and it somehow seems very removed from us, right? That almost the more people who die or are hurt, the harder it is to kind of empathize with that because it becomes something vast that we can't comprehend. And what I hope to do, at least with fiction, and I think what most authors or most filmmakers attempt to do when they fictionalize a story is is reflect the humanity of a few individual people, and in that way sort of tell everyone's story through just a couple of characters. And I think in that way, through fiction sometimes, we're better able to empathize with, to feel compassion for, or identify with the victims of disasters like that. And in that way, I think when people around those who've survived a disaster can better understand their experience, it is a calming thing. It brings a sense of tranquility to that sense of chaos. I only get to pick one book to take with me for the rest of my life. I'm sure that most people would pick something big and long. I don't know, the Bible or some massive tome, but I might take Anne Fadiman's book, Ex Libris. It's a book about books. It's little tiny essays about writing, and that just charms me to pieces, and it makes me laugh out loud, and I read it over and over and over again when I want something to make me happy.